of the Henrietta Wells Livermore School of Politics. We are honored to be the host committee for this Black History Month presentation of the Black Forum, the State of Black America. I would now like to introduce our lovely president of the Women's National Republican Club, Catherine Lenihan.
Thank you, and I welcome again you to our wonderful club here for this wonderful Black Forum. I'd like to recognize these young men over here, if they would stand up, who go to the school, the Eagle Academy. Wonderful, wonderful. Now, if you would all please stand for the presentation of the colors by our young Marines of Westchester County. After that, our national anthem will be sung by an a cappella by Chanel Gabriel. Chanel, if you would come to the front. Thank you, Chanel. That was just beautiful, beautiful. Thank you, and you can all be seated now. I would like to introduce the first of our co-sponsors, Will Brown, chair of the Manhattan Republican Coalition's committee. Will.
Thank you. I'm going to make this quick. I just want to take this opportunity on behalf of the Manhattan Republican Community Coalition to thank all of you for coming out. Without your presence, this would not be possible. I also want to thank the individuals who all worked together quite intensely to make this event happen, quite frankly, in a short period of time, Jan and quite a few others as well. And most of all, I want to thank our panelists for agreeing to participate in this evening's Black History presentation, and I'd like us to give them another round of applause, please. And in closing, I want to just again recognize these young men over here from the Eagle Academy. I already warned them that they're going to get this throughout the night. They've been with me all afternoon, a few blocks down at the Hilton Hotel. So we've been working together all afternoon, and we thought we just marched them from that venue over to this venue and just keep them involved, keep them working, keep them participating in what we do. After all, when we talk about Black history and we talk about what it all means, it is these young men and people like them that these messages are intended. So again, thank you for coming, and hopefully we will have a wonderful, great evening. Thanks.
I'll be brief as well. On behalf of Arbor Rice, President and CEO of the New York Urban League, and I'm Rashid Thomas, President of the New York Urban League Young Professionals, we're glad you're here. We were glad to add our name to this event. Just a little bit of history about the Urban League movement. It is the oldest direct services-based civil rights organization in the nation. It assisted blacks who were moving from the South during the Great Migration to transition to the industrial North. We continue that movement with employment and education, also giving out millions of dollars in scholarships through the Whitney M. Young Scholarship that most of you all know of through the New York Urban League Football Classic. The Young Professionals Auxiliary serves as a training ground for the leaders of tomorrow. We're an auxiliary of 21 through 40 year olds, and we encourage dialogues such as this that foster that growth. Again, thank you, and look us up on the web at www.nyul.org. If you are not a member of the New York Urban League, you are out of your league, and we want you in the league. Thank you.
I'd now like to introduce Fred Baptiste, Vice President of Alpha Gamma Lambda Chapter of Alpha Phi Alpha. Thank you.
I'm going to continue with the trend of brief remarks. I do want to thank everyone for the opportunity for Alpha Gamma Lambda to participate in this forum. I think we cannot overstate the importance of this dialogue. We understand what is going on in our communities. We understand how the political dialogue is progressing. It's important for us to keep ideas out there. It's important for us to be working with each other, to communicate with each other, and to be innovators in coming up with new schemes of doing things. On behalf of the Brothers of Alpha Gamma Lambda, once again, I thank you for joining us, and I'm looking forward to a very, very positive and enriching discussion. Thank you very much.
Thank you. I'd now like to introduce Jan Face Glassman, co-founder of the Black Forum. Thank you.
Thank you, Patty, and thank you, Fred, for your comments on ideas. I apologize in advance for my voice. It's not doing well. When David, Patty, and I began the American Forum series 3 years ago, we recognized the need for grassroots discussion of issues. Our slogan evolved into the three R's: real people, real issues, real answers. Citizens are more informed on issues and demanding candidates who address these issues head on. We learned this during recent elections. For example, in New Hampshire, I see more people becoming involved for the first time and attending local political meetings to work within our political structure. It is no longer acceptable to just say no or to repeat the same old talking points. We must become responsible and begin to define solutions for the how. Coalitions play a critical role in defining the various aspects of issues so that comprehensive solutions will address them. The Black Forum is the first of a coalitions-based look at the major issues that concern us all. Please enjoy our panels and get involved in ongoing discussion here and when you leave. I would now like to introduce my co-founder of the Black Forum, David Webb, host of the Grindr radio show in New York City and radio and television commentator.
Thank you. Thank you all for coming. Thank you all for giving your time. Thank you. It's nice to start off a panel with four very good friends, and I hope soon to be a good friend, Doug Banks. Or David Banks, rather. See, I put you in a famous name already. This is the beginning, as I said in the press conference. We will do this on a regular basis, but what we need to do is to begin with the very first step, which is an honest broker's dialogue. If you brought your talking points, leave them. I'm not going to accept them. I'm a tough moderator. What I ask of our panelists and our viewers and our audience and the American community at large is that you change your way of thinking to a very simple few words. I will be factual, I will be honest, and I will use my First Amendment God-given right to free speech in a proper manner.